Hi loves, how's it going? My name is Anne Lay and I created the Creative Minds Journal, which is the only journal out there that encourages creativity and productivity. That way you can exercise your right and your left brain in order to find balance and clarity in your life. So with that being said, today's journal entry is going to be about 10 tips to boost your productivity. Let's go ahead and dive into number one. Number one is going to be a no-brainer, but usually the obvious are the ones that we tend to forget. So this is a reminder to you, and that is to get some sleep, to get a good night's rest. You want to get about 7 to 8 hours of sleep per day. And if you're not getting that at all, that can be the cause to your mental state and also your happiness. This really, really affects your mood during the daytime. So if you're feeling grumpy and down most of the time, you may want to take control of your sleep pattern again. We're living in such a fast-paced world and it's really, really easy for us to just like get into work and other things in life and we forget to take care of ourselves. Something that helps me is to get sunlight in the morning, and that is to go outside and get about 10 to 15 minutes of pure sunlight. You want to go out, drink a little coffee or tea or walk your dog, whatever it is, just go out there and be in the sun. The best time of the day to go out and get some sunshine is around 8 a.m. because that's when the sun is out at its best. It's not too strong, it's just enough for you to get a little bit of that vitamin D, that little sunshine, and it really helps with your circadian rhythm as well, which is your internal clock that helps you wake up and go to sleep at night. Blue lights are the most invasive lighting out there. If you can stay away from a lot of electronics like 2 to 3 hours before bedtime, that would be really, really good and helpful to your sleep. I recommend just take like an hour or two to do other things you like catch up on reading, maybe cleaning up, doing the dishes. And so that way when you hop into bed, your mind and your body is ready to get a good night's rest. The blue light can definitely keep you awake and interfere with your circadian rhythm. Number two is take care of your brain. You want to take care of your mind, body, and soul. When you're taking care of your brain, you're also taking care of your body and your health and your well-being. So a few things that you can do to take care of your brain is one, diet. A diet will not only help and take care of your brain, but it will help take care of everything else. So think of wholesome foods. There are so many like lists of healthy brain foods out there to check out. All you have to do is Google search. There are books, but I'm going to go over three of my favorites. So avocado is one of my favorite foods. It's full of omega-3 fatty acids, which helps with the absorption of nutrients. These are good fats that help increase your feel-good chemicals into the brain. It also regulates mood and emotions. So if you want to be in a good mood, eat good food. Tomatoes, I love tomatoes and avocados together. They are so delicious. Tomato contains high levels of 2 mood-enhancing nutrients. That's folate and magnesium. And magnesium is so beneficial in so many ways, like for your hair, for sleep, just your overall health. So definitely look into that as well. Dark chocolate. The darker the chocolate, the better it is for you. And this helps with the blood flow to the brain. It also contains a lot of mood enhancing properties and also helps you with focus and your cardiovascular system. Other things you can do to keep your mind healthy is taking care of the state of your mind. I like to do mindfulness exercises in my journal. Usually in my journal, I just go to like the mind spill page or I go to the interpretation page. Doing the improv artwork also helps you stay present, mindful, and aware. So journaling is really great for mindfulness and staying present. Number three is to be around healthy people and people that inspires you. Now I know that in like the entrepreneur space, in the business space, they say that you are the 5 people that you spend the most time with. And a lot of people would tend to just gear toward the people who are rich and wealthy. And for me, I think what's important is to be around the people who are happy, like the people who are living life to their fullest potential and the people who knows what happiness really is. You want to be around those people, not what's in their bank account, because those people can be the most miserable people and that can reflect upon you. So find people who are just like living their healthiest, most happiest, and greatest life out there. So anybody who's really into fitness, health and fitness, and they're really happy about it, they're really excited and passionate about what they do, people who are into like gardening or something like that, people who find passion in their lives, you wanna be around those people because those are the people that will inspire you to live your best self. Number four, this is going to be super, super difficult for a lot of you guys, but put your phone in a different room. I know when I do that, I really was able to like complete most of my projects or complete many of the things that are on my checklist. Usually when I have the phone on my desk, in front of me, in front of the computer, I just go back and I get distracted so easily. So now what I do is I put my phone in my bedroom, and although it's just a room away, I stay on my computer, and then I'm just like, once I'm in like my work mode, I'm just there. I'm like, oh, I can't get up. And I just like finish my work. And then when I really, really have time, then I walk to my room and then I would check my messages or whatever. So I highly recommend for you to do that. It really works and it's beneficial to you. So why not do it? I mean, the phone is such a huge distraction. It's fun, it's great, but you know, like always checking your messages, being on Instagram, it's like a drug. It produces dopamine whenever you go and you check for instant gratification on your Facebook or your Instagram. So try to stay away from your phone by putting it into another room. That will help prevent you from checking it every single second. You will be able to focus more on whatever task you're working on. Number five, this one is so, so simple. But write a to-do list. I always talk about this because this helps me so much. So I write a to-do list everywhere. I put it in my mind spill pages, and then I take that and I consolidate, I break them up, categorize them, and then I put them in my planner that is also in here. So I do a big mind spill, everything that's on my mind, and sometimes I would have like my journal near my bed or some paper near my bed, and then whenever I'm thinking of something, I just like write it down. I take all that and then I consolidate it in my planner of things that I need to do. From there, I just do a checklist. Like, be your own boss, be a tough boss too, and tell yourself to like finish all those tasks, write it down, write some commands for yourself so that way you could like get right to it. Having a checklist really just helps guide me throughout the day. It's like my little guide right there, and it's a reminder. I get so distracted easily that having the checklist right there is just, it helps me go back to what I need to focus on. So checklist is so easy to do and it's so easy to forget. So make sure to create a checklist. It would definitely help you out 110%. Number six, that is to reward yourself after every task you've done. So have little rewards here and there after each task. For me, I know that editing a video is very tedious, and so sometimes I would break in between times and just get distracted, do something else, and that just makes my workflow like lengthier and drags on. So in order for me to like complete this project and be a little bit more efficient, I would reward myself. If I finish this task within 3 hours nonstop, I will reward myself by doing something I really, really wanted to do, like baking banana bread. So when I'm editing the video, in my mind, I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna finish this video. And then after I finish this video, I'm going to have a great time in the kitchen baking my banana bread without having to stress out that I need to finish, complete this video later on. I can do this with a clear conscience, with a clear mind, and just be my happy little self baking my banana bread. Number seven is set the right environment. You want clarity around you. You want space around you so that way you can create That way you can invent. That way you can produce. So make sure that your environment is nice and clear of any clutter. So before you work on a big project, clean up your space. And you want good lighting at the same time to set the right mood and tone. You want to feel relaxed in your environment, and lighting is really essential to that. Also, smell. Smell really helps. So if you set some aromatherapy around the area, like use a diffuser or something like that with some essential oils. So if you don't have a diffuser, that's okay. Just crack a window or something. You want some fresh air to circulate in your space. That way you can feel fresh, invigorated while you're working. Number 8, instead of focusing on the problem, focus on the solution. The problem is a good starting point for you, but you want to focus more on the different kind of solutions that you can use in order to get out of your problem or your issues. There are 3 modes of thinking: convergent, divergent, and lateral. Now, convergent and divergent synchronize with each other, but convergence is usually you have one answer and that is it. You know, there's only one answer to the problem. Divergent, you become more creative. You think of different creative ways you can solve or to get to this answer. And usually convergent and divergent thinking works together, because usually you have like an issue and you want to think of different solutions. And once you have the right solution, there is that one goal. And then there's lateral thinking. Lateral thinking is more exponential. You're thinking beyond what's in your bubble. You're thinking beyond the box. That is how innovators think, like people who create new ideas and revolutionize the world. So instead of just dwelling on the problem, there are so many solutions out there that will open new doors and windows and ideas for you. So remember, the problem is not going to do anything for you. It's not growth. The solution will help you move forward. And how you want to come about that is up to you. Number 9, and that is to say no. Say no to anything that doesn't have to do with your end goal. There are so many distractions out there, and it's so easy to want to do a little bit of this, want to do a little bit of that. Sometimes we don't say no because we're afraid to let people down too. But when it comes down to what is your priority, what is it you really want to do, accomplish, and where exactly do you want to see yourself in a week, 2 weeks, a month, or the end of the year? So I get invited to a lot of events around LA, and I stop going to these events. And although they are fun, I learned how to say no just because it doesn't serve my overall goal. I don't want to be going to events year after year and that's it. You know, it gives me great content to Instagram about, but that's about it. It doesn't serve my overall goal of where I want to be in my life. And I stay home and just focus on my work. I want to craft my work and master it. Number 10, and that is to organize your ideas. Write it down. I love having my journal around because I get to, you know, just the practice of writing it on paper. It's almost like a kinetic kind of exercise. You know, you're writing down all your tasks and you're reviewing everything that you want to accomplish in your mind while you're, you know, working your hands. So I love organizing everything on paper, and I would also use my calendar on my phone as well. As much as you can repeat all your tasks, your to-dos, it's really, really crucial. It helps you review and refine it. So whenever I get super, super overwhelmed, I just go in my Mindspill page and I just dump out everything, all the notes in my head. After my Mindspill page, I then categorize it and take different parts and put it in my planner or my phone's calendar. So it's almost like taking everything, all the ideas in your head out and just putting it in the right place, so that way you can plan out your life and live it. At the end of the day, you just want to focus on your craft, master it, and make it happen. Create your best life. So if you want to get a hold of this list, make sure to go to creativemindsjournal.com, sign up for our weekly emails. Other than that, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Ciao!